Hey everybody, thanks for checking back in for another video. Today we'll be in northern Idaho. We're working on this little neglected donkey named Trigger. Little history on Trigger. I was told his previous owner has been sick for a while, for a couple years, and recently passed away. And a neighbor, who you can see up there in the corner of the screens here, feet, she's holding the donkey, came over and offered to help clean up the place and offered to help find home for the animals. When she did that, she didn't realize how bad a shape the Trigger's feet were actually in, as you can see from the pictures up in the corner. So out of the kindness of her heart, before she found homes for the animals, she decided she'd better pay to get their feet taken care of. So that's where I come into the story. That's what brings us here today. Hope you enjoy the video, and I personally never done that one this bad, so don't know that the way I did it was the best way, but it seemed to go pretty smoothly, and I ended up liking the results, so hope you like it too, and let us know in the comments if you have any suggestions or thoughts as you're watching the videos. Forgot to mention a second ago, I did decide to make this video into a two-part video. So at the end of this video, if you do want to see how good Trigger's feet turned out, make sure and hit the part two of this video, and we'll make sure and put a link there so you don't miss it. Right.
Wow. Different.
We're making a little bit of progress. Take a second here to answer questions I've had on some past videos. Seems to be a common question, and the question is if what we do as farriers, if it hurts the horses, if trimming their hooves like this hurts them. The answer to that is basically like when me and you trim our fingernails, as long as we don't go too deep, we're not going to hurt them. We're just trimming off dead material that out in the wild would have gotten rubbed off by the abrasion of walking around, but because we keep them in confinement, we need to stay on top of it and trim off what would have been worn off in the wild. So the kind of the thing I'm trying to do now is like bring his heels back to where his heels will bear weight, you know, instead of curling under. And so it's going to look kind of funny. It's going to be like flat on the bottom and then straight up. Uh-huh. And then...
and that'll help him wear, right?
Yeah, yeah, that'll help him not only wear correctly, but hopefully start growing correctly instead of just keep growing. You know what I mean? Because I guess like job security, I could just, you know, you just let them keep growing out and then, you know, and then you just keep trimming them. But, I mean, granted, you will have to keep trimming them. But if you can get like the pressure coming up to the foot the right way, it'll grow correctly instead of keep growing, if that makes sense. But this is the end of part one for this video. If you'd like to see how Trigger's feet end up, we'll put a link right here to the second part of this video.